Alrighty, so today I'll be recapping the Red Sox and Rays series that just concluded yesterday from Fenway Park. So game one of this ALDS, it would be Eduardo Rodriguez to take the hill for the Sox against the rookie Shane McClanahan for the Rays from Tropicana Field. To start off, the first run would come via the rookie Wander Franco, doubling in a run. A Rosarena would be the one to score from first base to give Tampa an early 1-0 lead. The second run of the inning came thanks to a Yandy Diaz infield single to third. Franco would score thanks to Diaz reaching first base safely on the play. This made the game 2-0 Rays. Moving on to the third, the Rays would put up another run. This time, Nelson Cruz would hit a solo job to center field. The ball actually hit the second catwalk at Tropicana Field, and it was ultimately ruled a home run. This bomb gave the Rays a 3-0 lead. Moving on to the Rays half the fifth, the Rays would get their fourth run of the game, which came off the bat of Randy Arozarena, because Arozarena would hit a solo home run, and that swing made it 4-0 Tampa. Then Tampa's final insurance run would also come thanks to Randy Arozarena, because in the seventh, Arozarena decided to make the daring decision of stealing home plate. This risk paid off for the Rays, as Arozarena would be called safe at home plate, and Tampa would take a 5-0 lead. In the end, the Rays would win game one by that score of 5-0 and take an early 1-0 series lead. The line of game one would look like this. The Red Sox would score 0 runs on 9 hits and commit 0 errors. The victorious Rays would score 5 runs on 6 hits and commit 1 error. The Sox starter Rodriguez would only last 1 2/3 innings, while the Rays starter McClanahan would go 5 full innings. For game 2 in this series, it would be the veteran Chris Sale for the Sox against the rookie Shane Baz for the Rays. The top of the first, the visiting Sox would get the scoring started via a Xander Bogaerts RBI single to right. Schwarber would score on the play to make it 1-0 Sox, stays a 5-2 lead. Moving on to the third, Boston would get 2 more runs back. Game 2's line score would look like this. The Sox would score 14 runs on 20 hits and commit 0 errors. The Rays would score 6 runs on 8 hits and also commit 0 errors. The Sox starter Sale would only go 1 inning. Boz would only go 2 1/3 innings for the Rays. In game 3, it was Drew Rasmussen for the Rays against Nathan Eovaldi for the Sox. The Rays would start the scoring thanks to an Austin Meadows 2-run shot to right field. Wander Franco would score on the play to make it 2-0 Boston. Then in the bottom of the first, the Sox would cut the Rays' lead in half as Kyle Schwarber hit a solo job to left field. It was 2-1 Rays after the Schwarber home run. Then in the bottom of the third, the Sox would eventually tie things up and take the lead in their half of the inning. First, Kike Hernandez would hit an RBI single to center field. Christian Arroyo would score to make it 2-2. Then Devers would hit a sharp RBI single to center field. Schwarber would score on the play to make it 3-2 Boston. The Sox would add another run in their half of the fifth as Hernandez homered to left field to make the game 4-2 Red Sox. Then in the top of the eighth, the Rays would tie things up. First, Wander Franco would get the Rays within 1 run after he hit a solo home run to left field to make the game 4-3 Boston. Then Randy Arozarena would double in a run as he smashed a ball to center, which scored Margot from third to make it 4-4. This game would not be decided until the 13th inning. Finally, in Boston's half of the 13th, Christian Vasquez would hit a walk-off two-run home run to left field and win the game for the Sox 6-4 and give them a 2-1 series lead. Game 3's line score would look like this. Tampa would score 4 runs on 10 hits and commit 0 errors. The Sox would score 6 runs on 15 hits and commit 1 error. The Rays' Rasmussen would only go 2 innings, while the Sox' Eovaldi would pitch 5. For Game 4, it would be Colin McHugh for Tampa and Eduardo Rodriguez for Boston. Boston would hit the board first. Rafael Devers hit a 3-run home run to center field. This gave the Sox an early 3-run lead. Next, Alex Verdugo would hit an RBI double to left. Bogarts would score to make it 4-0 Boston. Finally, J.D. Martinez hit a sharp RBI single to left, which scored Verdugo from second base to make the game 5-0 Sox. Moving on to the top of the fifth, the Rays would get on the board in that fifth inning thanks to an Austin Meadows RBI groundout, which scored Luplo from third. This made the game 5-1 Boston. An inning later, in the Rays' sixth, Wander Franco would clock a two-run shot to center to cut Boston's lead 5-3. In the eighth, the Rays would tie things up at 5. First, Kiermaier would double in a run from second base to make it 5-4 Boston. Then, Randy Arozarena would single to right field. Kiermaier would score on the play to tie things up at 5. Finally, the last run of the game and the series would come thanks to a Kike Hernandez winning sacrifice fly that he hit to left field in the bottom of the ninth. Danny Santana would score the winning run from third, and Boston would eliminate the Rays and move on to the American League Championship Series. The Sox would win the game by the score of 6-5. Game 4's line would look like this. Tampa would score 5 runs on 7 hits and commit 1 error, while Boston would score 6 runs on 12 hits and commit 0 errors. Tampa starter McHugh would only last 2 innings, while the Sox starter Rodriguez would go 5 full innings. So congratulations to the Boston Red Sox. They advance the championship series. We'll see what happens for the boys in Boston. That's all I got for today's video. Like, comment, and subscribe. Hope you guys enjoyed. And as always, I'll catch you guys later.